Rylands Shark, number one, Kieran Kavanagh. Number two, Alan Billington. Number three, Gavin Conroy. Number four, Craig Millington. Number five, Chris Kavanagh. Number six, Neil Percival. Number seven, Ryan Millington. Number eight, Mike Randall. Number nine, Stephen McDermott. Number 10, Ben Bailey. Number 11, Paul Walsh. Number 12, Chris Nation. Number 13, Chris Doggett. Number 14, Andy O'Neill.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the BARLA's Blackpool Bonanza here from Fylde, the home of Fylde Rugby Union. Got a double header, and we're going to start off with a Champions Cup final featuring Halton Sims Cross, the holders of the trophy, against Rylands Sharks. Both sides from the Kukri Northwest Counties League. Halton Sims Cross finishes champions, retaining the title, but this time under new coach Frank Malloy. Rylands Sharks, a creditable fifth, but they got to the final of the Lancashire Cup. They've got to this final, they were in the quarter-final of the Ace Insurance Europe BARLA National Cup final. And to kick off, the Rylands Sharks were in a predominantly sky blue with dark blue, black piping and shorts. Similar in the traditional all-black strip with red piping down the side of the field. Wolf George is the master of ceremonies in the middle. Ex-professional, been there, done it, read it. So if there's any chicanery, he'll have be aware of what to do, because again, he's been there and done it. And just give you the teams quickly as we're waiting for kickoff. We've got a drizzly day. Hopefully it'll brighten up. But the rain is going in the eyes of Rylands Sharks at the moment. So, Halton Sims Cross at number one, Kieran Kavanagh, and a late change at number two now. Alan Billington, three Gavin Conroy, four Craig Millington, five Chris Kavanagh, six Neil Percival, seven Ryan Millington, eight Mike Randall, nine Steve McDermott, 10 Ben Bailey, 11 Paul Walsh, 12 Chris Manson as it kicks off, 13 Craig Duggan, 14 Andy O'Neill, 15 John Manson, 16 Craig, and 17 Nicky Fox. These are the teams that have been given to me. So if they've got the wrong shirts on, I'm sorry, coaches, it's down to you, it's not down to me. As Simmy's come away from their own 20 land. I'll give you the Rylands Sharks when we have a slight break in play. Good run forward. Craig White puts a tackle in for the Sharks. Steve McDermott gets that ball out there, but Neil Percival can't take it, and it's a knock-on. So we'll give you the Sharks side at... who are now going to get the scrum, head and feet and possession. At number one, Carl Lloyd. Two, Carl Sherritt. Three, Craig Howard. Four, Paul Reynolds. Five, Craig Ribby. Six, Andy Milesdale. Seven, Craig White. Eight, Anthony Riley. Nine, Hayden James. 10, Matty Wilson, the player coach. 11, Phil Risley. 12, Gaz Hewitt. 13, Steve Smythe. Substitutes, 14, Phil Stevens. 15, Mark Robinson. 16, Christian Froggett. 17, Lee Thomas. And I'll repeat, these are the teams as have been given to me by the coaches, so they should be right. As wait for this come to take place now when it's fed there by Smythe. Smythe gets it out to Andy Mousedale. Mousedale puts a beautiful long ball out there to his centre, Craig Howard. Craig Howard loops. Superb tackle and a superb attack from the scrum. Without a doubt, a planned move. And it's a drive from the Acton half back, a couple of metres from the line. Mousedale thinks has the ball, jinks, drives it forward a few minutes, scored all the points in the 2019 win over Charleston Rovers to get to this stage. And it's a drive forward, ball comes loose, and it's hit, dip, dash, but it's picked up by Alton Sims Cross and play the first scrum. And I can envisage the ball going to Alton Sims Cross. I beg your pardon, I've got it wrong. Referee Wilf George is nearer than I am to it's there to play, and it's Rylands to put in. So early doors in this Champions Cup final. Rylands putting the pressure. Ball goes out to White. White gives it to Lloyd. Lloyd takes a tackle. Tackle by the opposite number, Kieran Kavanagh. Mousedale puts a sliding flat ball there to Paul Reynolds. Two tackles gone, but about 5 metres from the line. Mousedale at Acton half back. Puts a missed ball out there to Craig White, but he couldn't take it. And Simi's come away with the ball. Great hit there on Craig Noon. Put down on the 10 metre line by Rigby. Walsh drives it forward. But interference at the play of the ball. And the bottom line is that referee Wilf George is going to make his mark early on the game, and for people and that's not gone dead or up. Oh, it's a bit of a let off there for Sims Cross there. That ball looked as though it was bouncing back into play, but it went into touch, so it's going to be a great position for Steve McDermott to tap on the 20. Millington flicks it inside to Ben Bailey. Ben Bailey drives it forward, and it's a high tackle from Sharks. Little bit fractious early in the game, and not got a bad crowd on for the first game, and hopefully it'll get better as the games go on. But it's a penalty to Sims Cross for a high shot. Referee's just calling Paul Walsh over as he puts the clock up. And just having a quick word with him. Both sides can play rugby. From a Sharks point of view, they'll be hoping that they don't concede points early doors, as they've done in previous encounters, which included that BARLA Lancashire Cup final at Christmas time. After a number of postponements, the game went ahead and Simis came out 14-12 winners. But from an early stage, the Sharks were playing at catch-up rugby. So it's Simis then. They've got the wind behind them. They've got the rain behind them. And I suppose it's a case of getting points on boards early doors and see what sort of a win this will be going into the second half. So they're going to have a kick at goal for a high shot, and it's number 7 Ryan Millington steps back, two to the left, looking at the post. He hits it well. The flags go up from the touch judges, and it's Halton Sims Cross 2 Ryland Sharks 0. So Millington there put that over expertly, and that's just the start that the holders needed or wanted, and it's 2-0. And the Sharks are going to kick off, and that good work they've done in the early minutes has gone to naught, and now they're going to have to try and eke a mistake from the Sims Cross side. So driving it forward then. Noon. Long ball out. Attacking down that side there. Near the main stand. Good break. The ball comes loose and it's picked up by Simis. Little jink across there, a little dummy. Last tackle, Simmies. Yeah, Millington with that little break there. In fact, Millington's got it now. Chip over the top, bounces once. Bounces into the arms of Carl Lloyd. But, I think the expression a little bit over-enthusiastic comes to mind there. But ball picked up by the fullback. He's having a quiet word. The ball skippers. We'll see how strong this wind is now when he tries to put this into touch. And it's just a case of putting it in, doing the simple basics, making sure it goes into touch. So they're going to be attacking from like a 20 metre line. And Bale involved in that tackle. Good run initially by Gav Hewitt, and second tackle, a few more metres. Basic rugby league from the Sharks. Mosedale, he's well wrapped up. Took that pass from his half-back partner, Craig White. Aidan James down that short side. It's a punt downfield early in the tackle count. Bounces are just behind Keon Cavanagh, who's now making angle run, comes back, straightens up. He's well wrapped up though. Chris Cavanagh. Bailey, big lad. Millington from Jink. Takes the tackle. Steve McDermott at half back. Sharks player injured in back play. Oh, and kept hold of that did Mike Randall. Last tackle. Good set to six from the Sharks. Well, that's a difficult kick. Millington going towards the corner. But ball bounces out of play. And again, referee George holding up play. For an injury, it looks like number 10 player coach Matty Wilson, who's gets up gingerly, takes a refreshing drink, and he's trotting back into position. To tap it. Another drive forward. Matty Wilson, well, I don't think he's knocked on there. No, he's not. He's a penalty interference at the play of the ball. So that injury he's got up from, it's not affected him, and he's still made a great drive forward there at early doors, and he's a punts it downfield, about 18 away, and it's found themselves in a similar position as they did in the opening couple of minutes when they looked dangerous. But on the scoreboard, it's 2-0 to Huntington's Cross. Waiting for the ball. I know we've got some because I've seen them. Weddon James waiting to tap it. Wilson drives it forward, makes a good 5 metres. Three Sims Cross players and tackling, including Paul Walsh. Mosedale flicks it inside to Phil Risley. Risley makes a few more metres up to the 10-metre line. Two gone. Mosedale. It's a simple run around with Wilson. He makes an angle drive forward, and I think he's in. You know, referee's looking at his linesman. He gives a try, and it's player coach Matty Wilson's second tackle, an angled drive, and the underdogs, Ryland Sharks, lead 4-2.
First try of the game, number 10 from Ryland, Matty Wilson.
Well, that try came following a penalty, a little jink forward, then on the second tackle, Player coach Matty Wilson got it, made an angle drive, and he couldn't be stopped. And he went over, making a superb try to make it the Sharks 4, Alton Sims Cross 2, with Mousedale's kick to come. What a great start for this Champions Cup final. Mousedale has the extras, it's 6-2, game on. Well, it might be early doors. 10 minutes gone. Have we got a shock on the cards? Ryan Millington waiting to restart. See how strong this wind is. Bounces. Whoa, that's how strong it is. And cliche time. It's not about scoring the try. It's about making sure that you get through your first set of six when you get that ball back. Unfortunately, Sharks couldn't, and it puts Sims Cross now in a great position to put some points on the board themselves. Millington at scrum half. Picked up at the base. Great Duggan. Randall. Randall drives it forward. Percival, Millington, all that flattish forwardish, but it's a, I think he's giving it as well. That was number 10, Ben Bailey. But he's, yes, forward pass, looked like that from here. Speckies aren't happy, but it's been chalked off. Sharks scrum. Purcell involved in the tackle. Ben Bailey as well. And it's a penalty, interference at the play of the ball. One would assume that these players will get the message that Will George isn't going to stand for any of this. That's a quick play of the game, even though he's getting some stick from fans in that stand on the opposite to where we're filming and commentating from. Great drive forward. That's a bit tight. Run ball from Riley. Mousedale. Again, puts it downfield early in the tackle count. Bounces a couple of times behind Kieran Cavana. Experienced player. Been there, done it. Form of the RAF. Cavana, that's Chris. That's brother. Duggan drives it, some spins. Good defence at the moment. Scoop from acting half back, Matt Dermott. Makes a few more metres. Good tackle though. Reynolds involved. Millington, last tackle, puts it downfield. Straight into the arms. Sharks winger, I think it is, yeah, number 2, Carl Cherrett. Good tackle. And the Sharks player thought about offloading Carl Lloyd, but he thought better against it. It's Wilson who scored that opening try. Beg your pardon, it's Steve Smythe that. Mousedale runs everything for this side. And it's certainly not a one-man team as it's a drive forward from acting half-back from Aidan James. last tackle that are about 30 metres away, and it's Smythe. Smythe puts a little grubber in it, it pops up nicely for Kieran Cavanagh, who gets that ball and makes a few more metres. A little spin there, but the semi's play dumped to the ground by Craig Howard. They've got some space here now. Noon takes a tackle. He got Billington on his outside, didn't use him. Matt Dermott. Ryan Millington. Ryan Millington gets that ball out there to his half-back partner, Neil Purcell. Matt Dermott again. Long ball out to Millington. Millington tries to put a chip over. Comes off the Sharks player, I think. And it's Matt Dermott. Matt Dermott's going. He gets a look at the back. Matt Dermott's in. It's a try. 6-6 with a kick to come. Well, that try came from that delicate chip over. I think it came off a Ryland Sharks player. Sims Cross played to the whistle. I wasn't sure whether Will George was going to blow his whistle, but he didn't. Then the came out to Steve McDermott, and he went in from about 30 metres. So that's 6-6 with the try to come. And what better way for Sims Cross to reply than with that one? But it's all about sometimes the bounce of this funny shaped ball of ours. And it certainly bounced in the favour of Sims Cross on that occasion. So Ryan Millington setting himself up, see if he can turn that four-pointer into a six-pointer. Hits it. He chips it like a golfer. 8-6. Simmons are back in front. Cross have got the ball, springing it forward. Nothing silly. Neil Purcell. Ryan Millington. Ryan Mel puts a beautiful long ball out there. Well, going down that side, he found Craig Millington, who then found his winger. But he keeps holding the ball, keeps inside, but a superb missman ball from Ryan Millington, who has the ball once again. Flat ball there to Chris Manson, changes direction of play down that left hand side. He found a chink down there. Last tackle. Millington punts it downfield. But it bounces out of play. Carl Lloyd ushering it out. Craig White taps it. No, he doesn't. He does now. Smythe with that run. There's a little spin. I think that's Phil Stevens with the ball. And the drive forward. Paul's doing the work. James finds Mousdale. Mousdale punts it down the middle. Again, it's another one for Kieran Cavanagh to chase as it bounces into the end goal. It's not a bad chase by the Sharks. And he's well met by James, Hewitt and Stevens. This time it's Reynolds and Rigby put the turn in. It's out to Alan Billington. He he's tackled, and the referee shouted, "Don't drag him, get off him." Good calls from the referee as Simmy's come driving forward. This time it's Paul Walsh. Matt Dermott gets it out to Neil Percival. Offers it as a dummy, comes crossfield, puts a long ball there out to Craig Millington. Craig Millington finds Chris Cavanna. Chris Cavanna comes inside, but Simmy's certainly giving it some air with having the breeze and rain behind them as Ryan Millington puts it down for. Oh! I was going to say, what a great take from Carl Lloyd. Before they had time, he knocked on. And he holds his head, realises he's made a mistake. But all he can do now is forget about it and wait for the next high kick to come and just put it down to a blip. But can Simmy's take advantage? Been a fast opening 20 minutes play. Simmy's trying to keep the ball alive, giving it some air. And the Sharks game revolving round Mousedale. That's an awful ball that came out of the scrum, but it's well picked up by Craig Noon. He's tackled by Mousedale. Going down that short side again, and it's an angle drive. Mike Randall. Trough loads. As soon as we're quick to pick up that loose ball. Walsh drives, spins. We're about 15 metres away. Millington, Percival spins, offloads to Craig Millington. Millington gets it out to Duggan. Duggan going down that side. Cavanna joins the line, wrapped up, last tackle. Libby, grubber, a bomb and a drive. Millington, crossfield bomb. Bounces, and they've scored. I must excuse myself there, the stanchion was in the way, but it's a try on the last tackle then, and we'll give you the score as soon as we've got it, because it's wonderful stanchion that we've got it filed, kind of fixed it up.
I'm going to stand here, Lynn,
so we still don't know who scored that one. Apologies to everyone. We'll clear that up later on. But the bottom line is, on the last tackle, it was a crossfield bomb from Ryan Millington. And the Sims cross play was on hand to score it.
Great.
Yeah, call it old-fashioned if you know the players won't take advantage. So we got confirmation that it's Alan Billington who scored that try. So he's having a great day so far with his distribution, his kicking, his overall play.
Is that the one you bent? Make what chest size of the ref shot?
Fucking swallow it,
mate.
Well, Ryland Sharks there, they're in discipline, let him down there after some good opening tackles. Simmy set. Oh, and they tried to force him out to play, but he's kept it in well, and he's put a beautiful ball out there to Chris Manson, who drives it forward for a Sims cross. 14-6 head at the moment. 23 minutes gone.
Yeah, that one.
To Craig Millington. Puts a spin pass out to Noon. Noon takes a first tackle, comes inside, but he's a well wrapped up Reynolds involved in the tackle, the centre. Millington the scored, he gives it to Paul Walsh. Walsh drives it forward. Three Sharks involved in the tackle, including Gaz Hewitt.
Three of them.
Matt Dermott.
Where are you looking?
Ryan Millington. Little Jin. Crossfield run. Puts a ball there to Percival. And, he just couldn't take that. That looked forwardish from here, but it ball went behind him. But Ryland Sharks put the tackle in. He lost the grip of the ball.
Where's Ammo?
And it's. They got the ball, and now they've got the penalty for interference at that play of the ball. A superb run. Well, it takes so much, this referee. Another good drive forward, this time to the halfway line for him, Phil Risley. Nice day. Mousedale are acting half back, good run from Lloyd. Ball goes backwards and it's bounced on by Paul Reynolds. They'd be acting half back. I think he's to stop the turn the tackle count, there's no six. Mousedale thinks about passing it out, takes a tackle. Short of the halfway line, the ball's come loose. And it's a knock on, good Aslin. From Halton Saints crossing the shape of Chris Manson and Craig Duggan. Still got the drizzle, considering the weather and the wind. Some good stuff being played in this opening half of this Champions Cup final. Noon. Wrapped up upstairs and downstairs. Kieran Kiravanna. It's an half back. Just drives it forward, spins a few more metres, 10 metres inside the Sharks half. Angled run now from number 18. I'm sorry, coaches, I've no idea who that is. So Craig Millington drives forward. So Ryan, I beg your pardon. To Neil Percival. Another good run. That's grubber from Matt Dermott, who scored the cross-opening try, and it's a knock-on, and it's a... Well, he's having a nightmare. Carl Lloyd, superb grubber from Steve Matt Dermott. Lloyd went down, it was an awkward ball, couldn't take it, so it's going to be scrum head and feed. 5 metres from the try line. And they've got to hold them at bay here. Can't let a Sims Cross run away in the first half. Duggan. Right in the tackle, trying to redeem himself again as it's an angle drive from Nicky Fox. A protective helmet. Number 18, whoever he is, drives it forward a few metres, but he's pushed back. Doesn't make any ground at all, and well, referee's not happy with the way that the player lashed out with his legs, so it's a let off for Rylands Sharks, and also as much as anything for the fullback. But like I said, try and find out who this 18 is at half time. Drive from Phil Stevens, simple rugby league. Matt Robinson, clear his favour with another good drive. Inside ball. Phil Stevens drives forward, Simi's asking for a knock on, but they're not going to get it. Craig White pumps it downfield, it's a good chase from Craig Rigby, but it's picked up by Kieran Kavanagh. It's a good run. And he's finished off by Paul Reynolds. Alan Billington, scorer of the second Sims Cross try. Doesn't make any headway on this occasion. Chris Noon. Good tackle there, Aidan James. Ryan Millington is running the show for Sims Cross at the minute. And he's pushed backwards. Steve McDermott. Neil Purcell steps off his right. Last tackle, good set of six this from Ryland Sharks. Ryan Millington, another punt downfield. Oh, and it bounces. Well, I was going to say wickedly, the fullback went for it, Kyle Sherrett, when it bounced, just thought he'd see where it'd go, and they're going to get the Adam feed. Not sure whether they're aiming to try and get the ball to Carl Lloyd or not, but Lloyd's just got to forget about those two little mistakes he's made and focus on what he's got to do ahead of this game. Oh, Millington puts a tackle there on Paul Reynolds. To run Craig Howard. Quick play of the ball, and it's picked up by Craig White. Craig White gets it. Well, they're all doing it. We've got a number 19 now for Ryland Sharks. I've no idea. Try and get the names to those numbers at half time. Still punts it downfield and it bounces wickedly, and Chris Cavanagh again lets it bounce into touch. I wanted it to make any mistakes or knock on or anything like that. Duggan picks it up at the base. Drives forward. Noon. Good tackle. Good tackle. Doing a little scoop from acting half back, but he's well policed. Ryan Millington. Oh, and he tried flicking it inside to Craig Millington. And yeah, it was a forward pass. I think what's happening is that we've got the referee working with his touch judges, and as long as it continues, three both halves will be okay. So Ryland Sharks are going to have this attack. It's probably the best position they've had for the attack since that opening try that they scored on 10 minutes. White, Reynolds, and he puts the tackle in with Billington. The big Ulster acting half back. Little angled run, short of the 20 metre line. Walsh involved in the tackle. Mousedale puts a flat ball in, and thought he got through the first phase, but he hadn't. Mousedale again acting half back, goes right, then goes left, gives it to Phil Stevens. Oh, and they dump him down. Now I'm ceremonious. I think he may. Yeah, they've got a penalty. Well, did they go for two? Did they go for a six pointer? Aidan James inquiring. Had a great position though. Second set of six, and they tap it. Mousedale just puts a leisurely ball out there to Lloyd, who'd surely love to get over the whitewash. White, oh, and he loses his footing. Mousedale, little angle grummer into the in goal, and it's a good play there by Chris Cavanagh, played safe, punted the ball out of play, so it's going to be a drop out from Sims Cross. So a bit of sustained pressure from the Warrington side, Ryland Sharks, in the first Champions League Cup final. Illustrious history. Ryan Millington puts it outfield and it's taken by Aaron Lloyd. Oh, what a hit! Craig Millington. Christian Froggatt drives him. Warrington side up to the 20 metre line. Miles Dale. White. It's that ball out. Three in the tackle. 20 metres away. Referee Lucas glancing at his clock. Mousedale. Mousedale gives it to White. White puts the grubber. It's like a game of bagatelle. And it goes backwards. And it's number eight. Mike Randall drops on it for Simmies. So nothing comes of that pressure as Billington tries to help out his forwards. And the first tackle. Sharks claiming. Well, Sharks were claiming a knock on. The linesman on our side with a red flag saw and found a ball steal. So that sustained pressure now comes to nothing. Well, I'm not sure where this ball's going. No, it's not going to end up. They're going to tap it instead. It's Ryan Millington, goes himself. It's a few more metres. But nice bit of pressure by Sharks, but they couldn't turn it into points. Nicky Fox. Angled run. Another drive forward. Randall. Randall offloads two at Ryan Millington. Spins. He's got quick feet. Gavanna. Kieran, that is. Offloads, gets it to Ryan Millington, who finds a beautiful ball there to Percival. Oh, and it's superb defence, and the ball's come loose. Oh, it's not. Last tackle. Superb break. Can they hold them out? I think he's got over there, not doing it. He's going to consult his linesman, because they've not moved behind the H's, is what you'd expect. But if that's a save, it's a superb tackle. Dermot drove up from the play of the ball. But that pass from Randall, he's disallowed the try. So that's two that Sims Cross have had chalked off. It'll be interesting to see what he's given it. He's, I think he's indicating a knock on there. Well, now I'm assuming he's given it for that try, or unless he's given it for the tackle before that. But the bottom line is, it's still the same score, 14-6. I thought I was losing things there with that scoreboard. He's replacing it to 14-6 instead of 18-6. And it's going to be scrumhead and feed to the Sharks. But that was a superb break there by Neil Percival, and it was superb defence that stopped him, because he looked odds on a scorer on that occasion. We've got 3 minutes left, and it's it certainly rattled along this game, and Simmies may end up at some stage, if it goes different in that second half, query the validity or invalidity of the two tries that they've had disallowed. But the bottom line is, the touch judges are there to do the job, as is the referee, and it's an ambitious grubber in his own half by Mousedale, but he couldn't catch Kieran Cavanna out. He picks that ball up, and Craig White puts a tackle in. In fact, the clock's running quicker than ours. So at half time, the score is Halton Sims Cross 14, Rylands Sharks 6. Started off sensationally, a quick penalty from Millington. That was followed by Wilson scoring a try for the visitors. It was converted, made it 6-2. And then a superb chip over, bounce the ball. Steve McDermott scored a converted try, made it 8-6. And then second try, this time it came from Billington, converted, making it 14-6 at the break. So how strong is this wind? Some of the Sims Cross people are just asking about that try disallowed. But the bottom line, it's 14-6, more to come in the second half.
Nothing we can do, I mean.
Shellers!
Well, welcome back. First of all, apologies. The 18 and 19 with no idea who they are for each respective side. We've not been able to get who it is. I've checked on the team sheet that I got, and it doesn't relate to any number changes. So apologies to both sides, and apologies if they score the points, because that's, if we don't get the information, we can't do nothing about it. Anyway, that's my grouse done. Let's get back to the action now as the second half started. And the question is, how strong is this wind as Sharks get the first set of six possession? And it's a punt downfield, the 14-6 behind, playing catch up. Kieran Cavana comes away with it, but it's a good chase, and it's Gaz Hewitt who, with his colleagues, dumps him to the ground. Christian Frogger involved in that tackle, and it's Craig Noon driving it forward. A few more metres. It's a good drive forward. Hayden James involved. Christian Frogger involved, but the flag waver's on. He's seen something. As Steve McDermott's ready for a scooting from acting half back. So he's taking instructions. Have a number 19, whoever is, a picture of innocence. But it's looking like it's going to be a penalty to Alton Sims Cross, and it's for an elbow in the tackle. And because of the main road travelling behind the main stand, that's why the referee are doing just 10 metre walks for penalties on that side of the field. All right, the attacking side loses advantage, but got to think about where the ball might go if it's kicked. And here come Alton Sims Cross in the guise of their number 18. Steve McDermott, acting halfback, ball flicks it inside there to Lee Thomas. McDermott again to Ryan Millington, standout in the first half to Percival, his halfback partner, looks a bit forward to Kieran Cavana. And make a few more metres. Neil Percival. Little angled run, looking for the gap. Pushed back a couple of metres. Last tackle. And the tester, Lloyd again. Ryan Millington. It's a crossfield chip. It's spiralling ball. I'd say he's offside the number four, but it's number five, Chris Cavana. I think he's going to give it. I thought that Craig Millington was offside. What do I know? Will George points downwards, and it's 18 points to 6 to get the try this time. So that try then on the last tackle, it was a crossfield bomb from Ryan Millington. The Sharks winger couldn't take it, and the ball fell kindly so that Chris Cavana could collect the ball, and he went in at the corner, and that's Sims Cross third try, and it's 18-6, and Ryan Millington's going to try to kick into that wind to add the extras.
Two loops. The phone's for sale. The great cast for sale. Two loops. They'll cover that.
I know you're people went mad on the phone. But the spectator is here, we're away for you now.
That's the best thing you should have done. He said, yeah, I'll meet you outside the ground. And then 30 of them met him.
What a magnificent kick from Ryan Millington, and he's having a great day. Increases the lead now to 20 points to 6. Well, that's the last thing that the Sharks wanted, but came from that penalty, if we think about it, when the flag waver came on, and they certainly made Ryland Sharks pay with that. A Little jump forward from Sims Cross. The title in winless title in style last season. Are they going to do the same again? As it's a little break from Neil Percival. The ball goes backwards. It's well picked up by Mike Randall. The Sharks try to put him into touch, and I think somewhere along the line, Wilf George, the referee's found a forwardish pass. And that's the state of play, that's what's happened. So it's going to be a scrum head and feed to Ryland Sharks.
Fucking proper blurt first, didn't he? Don't tell him, he's on Sky, wasn't
he? Referee just holding up play. Sure they don't need the water. So they pack down. Good ball there out to Craig Howard. Well, they've got to respond with a try, you feel. Back into this game, but a goal drill under from Anthony Riley of the Sharks. Mousedale adapting half-back. It's a flattish looking ball there to Wilson, who scored the opening try. Well, that was a good swat. Scored the try at the beginning of the game to give the Sharks a 4-2 and then 6-2 lead with a conversion. Craig White takes a tackle out, 20 metres out. Mousedale chip to the end goal, bounces once, and it's a good experience play from Alan Billington, puts the ball dead. It's going to be Sims Cross second drop out of the game. One in the first half when they had to withhold a steady bit of pressure in that opening 3 or 4 minutes. Sharks have had another good period in that half, but they've not taken advantage here when they've had the ball. And against a side as experienced and strong in defence as Simmons, that's what you've got to do. So can they make them pay here? It's picked up by Lloyd. Lloyd makes 10, but he's well wrapped up. First in tackle there, Ryan Millington. Jinx stop, looks for some gaps. Taylor keeps hold of the ball. Oh, what a great tackle from Froggatt. Nicky Fox. White. White gives it to Wilson. Wilson picks a flat ball there, but it's sliding defensively and Pierce again from Sims Cross. Scoop from acting half back. Oh, and it's given a penalty, I think, not being square. So another chance for Sharks. Can they turn this pressure into points? They've got to get a six-pointer on that board. Smythe drives forward. Push backwards. White. It's long ball out. And the ball comes loose. And Simmers have got it back. Well, you've got to complete your sets. You needed to complete that sets near the line as Chris Cavanagh, scorer of that last Sims Cross try, helps out his defence, but referee Wilf George holds up play for an injury to a Shark in back play. But they're now playing catch up with the Sharks and losing that ball then early in that tackle count hasn't done their campaign any favours whatsoever.
I'm shaved specially.
20 points to 6. At the moment, it's still rain in the air. Wind isn't as strong as it's been. We've always been lucky at these fans. We've been doing it here at Fylde or at Blackpool. The sun's come out to play, but it's not come out at the moment. And this wind is blowing towards the houses, Magnificent Social Club end, which is the backdrop at the end that the Sharks are defending. Anyway, everybody's okay, and here we go again. And it's Craig Millington up on his forwards, eh? Wearing protective headgear.
Is it as good as
better every?
Sorry, this game. It's almost.
And you can only say that Wilf George is doing it his way, because now he's penalised. The Sharks are not being square at the play the ball, and I'm sure they did the same to the opponents a short time ago. So again, it's a 10-metre tap. Looks like Paul Walsh. Superb offload. Crossfield strings up. Takes the tackle. Chris Cavana gets through the first one, spins, takes the tackle. Matt Dermot at acting half back. Ryan Millington. Passing it, takes the tackle himself. Walsh. Tackled on that far side. It's Nicky Fox, last tackle on the halfway line. Ryan Millington. Oh, that's a nice spiralling ball. Lloyd goes for it, and Lloyd picks that one up superbly. And then he offloads now. Can the counter attack? Jarrett tried to do that, but he's wrapped up by Chris Cavana. He fought one of the unnamed forward. Looks like a bit of cramp there. Definitely holding up the clock again.
He's just having a debate what it is.
But Carl Lloyd will be happy to have picked up that, caught that punt. He let one out the wind horribly. Didn't help him in the first half when he let one go. Dropped to the ground. And then later on, he knocked on following a grubber. But referee's going to allow the action to continue while this player's treated to him back play. And it's number 13, Steve Smythe, drives it forward just inside the semi's half.
I was trying to drive home.
Oh, that's a beautiful ball out there to Anthony Riley. But it's Duggan who puts the tackle in.
How long was your training?
It's not happy, isn't it, Riley? But the referee is. White puts a flat ball out there to spin from Paul Reynolds. It's a cracking tackle. Last one. A nice spiralling bomb. White's got to get his players onside, and Cavana can't take it. He misses the goal. Where are we going? We had a try here. George goes back. He's looking at his linesman. Well, he's giving it, and Sharks are back in the game. Give you the score as soon as I've no idea is the answer to that one. But score 20 points to 10 with a kick to come. Well, somebody with better eyes than me says that it's Paul Reynolds who scored that try, but basically on the last tackle, White put a high bomb in, Cavana couldn't take it. Reynolds picked it up, went over. Now, if Mousedale can put this over, it's game on again. But is this when the fight back begins? What they've got on for
red, obviously, or black.
Black polos
and a red tricky. That's it, that's the new Puma gear. Track it top red and polo black.
Well, the fight back begins. Mousedale adds the extras and it's 20 points to 12. Well, we've got to keep this set of six going. Sharks, can they come back? 8 points behind. Still plenty of time. Well, like I say, it's a funny shape ball. Whitey put that last ball up, he puts it downfield now then. We've got the wind and rain behind him as it bounces a few times. It's picked up by Billington, who scored since got second try. Player vast experience. Oh, and the ball's come loose again. And they've got him into touch, so there's the momentum of this Champions Cup final changing. Simmy's appeared in control. But now we've got another fight back by the Sharks. They are feeding off scraps. But back to the wall at the moment then for the Widnesians, the holders of this title, every final in this competition in its various guises. They've won. Oh dear! Well, that's the last thing you wanted from the scrum. Knock on, I think it was from Craig White. Billington was on it like a rash, punted it downfield, tried chasing it, but I think the ball was put into out of play by one of the Sharks players at running back. But well,
who's number four?
It's the last thing you want to do when you're about 10, 15 metres from an opponent's try line and knock on at the scrum. Well, that's what the Sharks have done. They've got again, forget it. Just seems cross over there, they're quite pleased. They could deep breathe Lee and try and counter attack now. They've done it initially in the shape of Kieran Cavanna, and now Steve McDermott's made a couple of more metres. It's another drive forward. So three Sharks involved in the tackle. On, number 8, Mike Randall. Ryan Millington. Little goose step, couple of goose steps. Still got the ball.
Yeah, I think we should take the ball.
Actually takes the tackle. Craig Millington gets it. Outside. Last one. Well, a good bit of hassling that. Simmy's aren't happy with that. I'm surprised that they didn't try and get that ball away with a bomb or whatever on that last tackle. But Rylands Sharks won't be complaining. Well, somebody's got a good opinion on the far side of the stand. Whether we picked it up, I'm not sure. But she's not up. I've got a thumbs up from the cameraman. We have. And now we've and he says thumbs up from the cameraman at Old Trafford. I don't know if he can get as far as Twickenham though for tonight. Anyway, after that it's a penalty for Rylands Sharks. Try four. It's Christian Frogger who's dumped to the ground there. Andy Mousedale asking for the penalty, doesn't get it. Craig White, flat ball there to Steve Smythe.
Norris has been out training.
Meters up the middle. Mousedale's still got it. And he puts a flat ball there. It's to his centre, Paul Reynolds. Scoring that last try. Changes a switch of play. And it's White. White, a couple of spins. Offload there. And it's a backward flip for them. Catch you it. Two fans. I could understand why they're doing it. The referee's saying play on, saying it went backwards. Mousedale, Andy Mousedale, gets that ball out there. Matty Wilson. Matty Wilson's tackle on that far side. Last tackle coming up. What are we going to get off this? It's White. Created the last one. Crossfield bomb. Oh, and it's well taken from Chris Cavanna. And I've got a better picture of that than the cameraman. He's got a beautiful picture in the middle of the floodlight stanchion. But ball's caught in goal, and it's going to be another goal line dropout, the third one of the game from Alton Sims Cross. Now, can Sharks turn this pressure into points? 8 in it.
I got an inbox message yesterday saying you're going to Blackpool.
Referees.
Someone else, no,
it's like the water boys on. Oh, what are you? But a bloodman, I've been told. Brilliant, these cameramen. They've got better eyes than me.
And I was like, yeah.
Some of you who know me say it's not surprising. Anyway, it's going to restart. There's Craig White, it runs back into position. It's a grubber. Right, lets it go past him. Bounces wickedly, picks it up, turns, and he's faced by Sims Cross charges. Oh, and he milked that. He milked that good style, did Carl Lloyd. So he's got over at the moment those jitters he had in the first half. Mousedale then. He's got to go forward 10 metres. A tap and restart. Hewitt. Good drive. White goes to acting half back. Gets the ball. It's a beautiful roll there to Steve Smythe. Ball's come loose again, but it's a knock on this time. I'd imagine the Sharks would argue that it had been stolen. So Simmies get the head and feed about 10 metres from their own line. And at the moment, the second half of the story, when they've had a chance of a fight back, is that the Sharks have lost it early in the tackle count. As they try to chase this 8-point gap. Percival. Sharks trying to force Simmies into touch, but it doesn't work. And it's an injury. Three or four players involved in that tackle, so referee holds up play. And the Simmies physio staff will come on and sort him out. But they're trying to force him into play. Didn't come off. But just going back to the story of the second half, it's 8 points in it. And there are a few times now that Rylands Sharks have lost the ball early in the penalty count in very, very good scoring position. I suppose as much as anything, you've got to compliment Rylands' cross defence, which is as steely as it's ever been. So he's still down. points to 12. Simmies have had two tries, disallowed one at the back end of the first half. One early door, so everybody's ready, apart from the whistleblower and the cameraman. Well, the cameraman's all right now, so is the whistleblower. That's Randall, that. Great game in the forwards. Millington, lemon across. Oh, and he tries giving it to Ryan. Tries giving it to Craig. The ball comes loose, and a sudden bit of dropsy from Halton Simmons cross inside their own half, about what 25 metres away from their own try line. How costly will that be? So we've still got the rain. White from the scrum. All of it, keeps all of it this time. They've got to get a try, you fancy or sense. Hewitt. Well, it's another penalty. That looks like that one's for dissent. They could go for two. But Mousedale decides that they're going to go for the six. I just wonder why they're not moving 10 metres forward. What do I know? White. Stevens. Millington and Matt Dermott involved in the tackle. They've got a little chink here at this side there. It's another drive forward, and it's Steve Smythe. Going down the short side now. Oh, and they're in for another try. It's number three, Craig Howard, and it's certainly game on now. That makes it 20 points to 16 with a kick to come. So there we had a couple of occasions there where we had a bit of dropsy when the Millingtons made a mistake. Rylands got the ball back and then they got a penalty awarded against them. And on the second tackle, instead of kicking for position, The ball came out to Craig Howard. He went over and it's 20 points to 16 with the kick to cut. Well, Mosdale missed that kick. It was a difficult one in these conditions, albeit that he had the win behind him. So there's 4 points in it. A converted try would give them the lead. But it's game on. Can Sharks carry on this fight back? They trail 14-6 at half time. Semi scored early in the second half. Make it 20 points to 6, but the Sharks have begun a comeback and they're only 4 points behind. And we thought this final was going to be tight, and so it's turning out. And it has been similar to what Matty Wilson really didn't want in a game, conceding points early doors and having to play catch up. That's what they've had to do after that. One stage they were 6-2 up. But now they're only 4 points behind and driving forward with confidence. But it's all up to me about that first set after you've scored. And up to the one halfway line. Craig White punts it downfield and it's one. It's bouncing on the ground for Craig Cavanna to HS. And the winger's going for it, but it's the kick's too strong from White. Spirited chaser. Craig Rigby, but he was never going to get it, but they're adapting to the conditions superbly at the moment are the Rylands Sharks. There's Chris Cavan Ritson spins, drives forward, helps his side out, scored the last try for Simmies. Another good drive forward from Sims Cross. Ryan Millington still running things for Simmies. Matt Dermott. It's a flat ball. And no need to do this. White puts a tackle in, but John Manson, I think, had that ball then. Went out on that short side. Neil Percival. Good sliding defence from the Sharks. Dead on halfway line. Last tackle. 2016. Ryan Millington. It's a cracking kick. Oh, and it's well taken by Carl Lloyd. That's through the first tackle. But he couldn't get through that tackle from Ben Bailey. And finished off by Gavin Conroy. Cavanna involved in the tackle there. That was Duggan. Phil Stevens. Changes direction, went down the short side. Looking for a chink in the armour. Craig Howard scored that last try. Andy Mosdale, another punt downfield, and it's one for Kieran Cavanna to chase, and it's bouncing into the in-goal. He's having a glance to see how far the chasers are. He picks it up, he's in his own in-goal, and it's a cracking run. Oh! That looked a little bit tight to me. And it looked a little bit tight to referee Will George. So, he's having a word with... It was Craig White who goes over to Kieran Cavanna, apologises, but I don't think Kieran's minded about the apology at the moment. But it's a superb chip and a great chase back out of his own in goal from Cavanna, and Sharks to some extent spoilt the good work from the kick. But just take the time now and get themselves back together, both Simmies and the Sharks, but it's been a superb game, this Champions Cup final. So if they take the ball 10 metres forward as Kieran Cavana gets up, shakes it off. Bravery of these amateur players who actually play to get a crack like that. And they pay the subs. Oh, he's had a superb game in the forwards for Sims Cross as Randall. Ryan Millington. Oh, that looked questionable. Millington. Walsh. Drives, spins, three in the tackle. Julian Gaz Hewitt. Oh, milking a penalty there. Referee's not having it. Steve McDermott gives it to Ryan Millington. Dummies left, dummies right. Last tackle. Another good set of six. 15, I think that was it. John Manson. And it's well collected by Ryland Sharks. Momentum, he's pushed back a few metres. Really? Or Riley? Whichever you want to call it. Riley, I think. Pronounce it. John Doe. He did well, he pulled that ball as he went down. Mousedale gives it to Aidan James. It's finished off by his opposite number, Steve McDermott. Last tackle. Craig White rubbers it forward. Will it bounce kindly for him? No, it bounces kindly for Kieran Cavana. Takes a good 20 metres. Kept his cool, and it's Chris Cavana now who helps him out now with the second tackle. As I said, he scored the last Sims Cross try. Greg Noon drives forward, just short to the halfway line. Walsh, she's wrapped up by James. Probing, Matt Dermott, another good run. Last tackle, Billington goes to Acton halfback. Manson, ball coming down the line. Ryan Millington gets it out to number 10, Ben Bailey. Ben Bailey gets it out to Chris Cavana. And he knocks. It's like he's given a penalty. He's given a penalty for offside on the last tackle. So they didn't run it, they're going to try and put the go for the jugular, and it's that to Mark Randall again who drives it forward. Could have gone for two, but they're going for the six. Matt Dermott gets it out to Ryan Millington. Ryan Millington's in, and if there was a time then to seal the man of the match, I think Ryan Millington has just done it with that superb individual effort from that flat ball, making it 24 points to 16.
Sims Cross 7, Ryan Millington, crowned with a 4-16.
Well, that could be the try that gets his Champions Cup final winner's name on of Halton Sims Cross. They could have gone for two, they decided to go for a 4-pointer or a 6-pointer. And the ball came out to Ryan Millington, made a little bit of a mistake that partially led to the last Sharks try, but on that occasion he got that ball, saw the gap, went for it, jinked through under the H's, and now he's in an opportunity of turning that 4-pointer into 6-pointer straight in front of it. It's 24 points to 16. Millington dead in front of the H's. Lining it up. He hits it, it's a superb try, and it's 26 points to 16 to Halton Sims Cross in this Champions Cup final. So we've got a couple of minutes left in this Champions Cup final. And it looks as if Halton Sims Cross, great tradition in this competition, are going to retain the title under a different coach this time, Frank Molloy, who took over at the beginning of the season. They've already retained the Northwest Counties Premiership Cup. They've got a penalty now, so they're driving for the jugular without a shadow of a doubt there. And it's Steve McDermott who's been influential throughout this game. But Ryan Millington has had an outstanding game for Simmies. And as we speak, he's just put that ball out there to Ben Bailey. He's well wrapped up. Chris Cavanagh helps out to winger. Gives it to Paul Walsh. Angled run, spins, drives. Steve Smythe involved in the tackle. Dermot again, a acting halfback, puts a flat ball out to John Masson. It shows and goes superbly, and he superbly flicks it out unselfishly to Kieran Cavanagh. That makes it 30-16, game set and match to the Widnesians of Halton Sims Cross. So that try came again as a result of a penalty. Simmy's got the ball, they drove down forward, and it was a magnificent break, and it was superbly finished off by Kieran Cavanagh when the passer of the ball could have got in unselfishly. But what a superb try with the kick to come. So it's 32 points to 16, and the rain's coming down harder, and we were hoping for a little bit of sunshine, pointing out to there's about a minute plus whatever the referee has on his clock for injury time. But a superb professional performance by Halton Sims Cross. Sharks were in it. They were at one stage, they're only 4 points behind, but you can't beat class. And even the coach, Matty Wilson, does say that that's what they are, a class side, Halton Sims Cross. But the rain pouring down, we were hoping that it was going to ease up, but it hasn't on this occasion, as again, Sims Cross have the ball. 16 points, no, they've scored more points in the second half, playing into the wind, and I suppose that's when the experience counts. Another drive forward as they try a ball steal. And it was John Manson who made that try. Superb effort, Millington. Millington gives it to number three, Gavin Conroy, who drives it forward, just up to their own 40-metre line. McDermott to Millington. Millington puts it downfield. Take from Rigby, comes inside. And it's a great tackle there by Paul Walsh. But this Warrington side, no doubt that they'll be challenging next season on every front. Good drive. It's Lee Thomas. Another drive forward, just short of the halfway line. Oh, the ball's come loose. Steve McDermott picked the ball up. There can't be long left now, but in a superb game. With George just glancing at his watch. Come on, a score of that last try. He only needed to hold that ball, and he did. Well, I think he's been the standout forward, Mike Randall. I think Ryan Melton may take the plaudits and the man of the match for this game. Drive forward, Neil Percival. Manson. Walsh. Drives. Oh, superb offload to Cavanagh. Cavanagh finds McDermott. McDermott's in! 36 points to 16. Well, that try was the Brucey bonus, and superb try. A superb effort, a superb try, orchestrated by Cavanna and finished off by Matt Dermott, and that makes it 38 points to 16. And when you look at this in the papers over the weekend, the score can be surely really cruel. They were only 4 points behind at one stage, but in that last 10 minutes, Simmers have shown what they are. A superb outfit, and it's another kick for Ryan Millington in front of the H's. And I'll not put him off because I remember the water final at Wembley. And Don Fox missed that one that could have given his side the challenge go. This one won't matter. Millington hits it. 16. Well, I don't know where referee's got this injury time from. He's, in fact, as we speak, the whistle goes. The winners of the Champions League Cup final, Halton Sims Cross a witness 38, the Ryland Sharks 16. And at one stage, the Sharks were only 4 points behind, but three converted tries in the last 10 minutes, 12 minutes, gave the winners edge to the home side. As they cheer on this particular game. Story of the game itself now, very briefly. It was 14-6 at half time. And then Sims Cross looked as if they'd taken control, 20 points to 6. But then the fight back began from the Ryland Sharks when they got a converted try to bring it back to 20 points to 12 after Kieran Cavanna had knocked on. Paul Reynolds went over the H's. Then, after a Millington mix-up, it was a penalty to Sharks, and then from that, Craig Howard made it 20 points to 16. We thought it were game on, but it wasn't to be, as Ryan Millington went over for a converted try. That was quickly followed by another try from a break where Kieran Cavanna went over after the good work had been done by John Manson. And then in the closing seconds, this time as a break from Kieran Cavanna, he made the break, slicked a beautiful ball out to Steve McDermott, who went over for the second try. Kick went over, 38-16. Ryland Sharks gave their all. But Halton Sims Cross a mighty outfit, and they retained this trophy, 38 points to 16, as the players are shaking hands and going through the customary after a game. And I'm sure that all enjoy a sherbet later on tonight. But the bottom line is, Simmers are the winners of the Champions Cup final.
Number 9 of Halton Sims Cross, Steve McDermott.
Well, Steve McDermott, the hooker for Halton Sims Cross, is coming up for the Man of the Match award. It must have been a mighty close thing between himself and number 7, Ryan Millington. But he had a superb game, scored a couple of tries, and was involved in a hell of a lot of things, and perhaps they go away unnoticed. But on this occasion, he's got the Man of the Match, superb performance, and now we're going to wait for the presentation of the teams.
16, fought it back to 2016, but not enough. Ryland Sharks.
And Ryland Sharks are runners up, put up a superb effort, got within 2016, but Simi showed that experience to move it up a cog in those last 10, 15 minutes, three converted tries. Gave them a superb victory. It looks unjust on the scoreline, but the Sharks will learn from this defeat, and I'm sure they'll come back an even stronger side next season in the Kukri Northwest Counties Premier Division.
The 2010 BARLA Champions Cup winners, Halton Sims Cross.
And here come Halton Sims Cross the witness. They've retained the trophy. It might be under a new name, but it's still the title, and the captain will come up last for the trophy. The captain, Paul Walsh. And, come on, lads, let's get shifting. It's throwing it down out there. Anyway, what a great performance. 38 points to 16. Worthy winners in the end. And the class and experience tool, especially that second half when they were playing into the wind and the driving rain. Come up for the medals, get a good oar, get a good ovation. Last man standing. And Paul Walsh, who's just waiting to collect this cup. And here he comes. Behind Kieran Cavanagh. The Mayor of Wigan and Chairman Sven Allison presenting the medal, and now they're going to present this trophy eventually. Well, I'm having a pregnant pause because he's still not got it yet. Well, normally I've got the gift of the gab, but I'm bemused at this. Well, let's all have a chat. Come on, give me a cup. So, all since cost celebrate after being presented with a Champions League Cup. They've retained the trophy. What a side. Champions.